time you zap. Check it.
Boom.
Ha ha. I'm here.
Straight out of your nightmares.
Excuse me?
Excuse you nothing. I'll excuse you as soon as we play a little football. You understand me, sweet tooth?
You don't play football.
Every day I do. ESPN, NFL, football, with the first person football feature. Wow. Because I don't play. You know something? Oh, there you go. The little birdie's talking to me. He's saying, Seth can't mess with you. Seth too slow.
Rated E for everyone.
A lot of people say, did you ever write any songs that didn't go anywhere? We got a whole backyard of songs that didn't go anywhere. But they say, what is the worst song maybe that you ever wrote? And maybe this comes closer. And Mark gets blessed every time I bring up this song. But this comes the closest to probably the worst song that I ever wrote. And I wrote it because an evangelist came through town preaching about compromise, and he used the Old Testament scripture that said, there's not a hoof shall be left behind, which was about Pharaoh and Moses negotiating about getting the children out of Egypt land into the promised land. And he would say, okay, you can go, Pharaoh would say, but leave your possessions here, or leave your horses here, or leave a couple kids here. And there were a couple kids that volunteered to stay there too, I think. But finally Moses said, no, we are going, the whole bunch is going, and there's not one hoof going to be left behind. And I got so excited, I thought, man, what? And I couldn't wait to get to the piano to write this stirring message about compromise. And I knew who could sing it. Jake Hess and Hovey and the Statesman, you could sing this and you could just make a hit out of it. And so here's the way the song went. Oh, Pharaoh had God's people in bondage. He would not let his people go, God's people go. Moses did pray for victory that day, that God his might would show. So Pharaoh said, Moses, you're free if all your cattle you leave here with me. Moses declined, he would not resign. There's not a hoof shall be left behind. There's not a hoof shall be left behind. When God speaks, his will must be done. The Lord Jehovah is reigning, and him alone I'll serve. There's not a hoof shall be left behind. My song, okay. Here's the application verse. So men today would still compromise. It has been said that each has his price. The world or its cattles or farms, the world or its charms, their Christ they crucify. God give us men like Moses of old, who won't sell out for the world or its gold. When Satan would lure, they'll stand fast secure. There's not a hoof shall be left behind. Sing it. Not a hoof shall be left behind. When God speaks, his will must be. The Lord Jehovah is reigning. Him alone I'll serve. There's not a hoof shall be left
filled with sorrow and plans for tomorrow, but this is the time I must sing. And I know there's a reason why in his God gives me a song I can sing. Oh, keep silent, ye mountains, ye fields and ye fountains. Oh, this is the time I must sing. Oh, it's the time to sing praises to the rock of the ages. Oh, this is the time I must sing.
If I've seen and I've done and I've gained and I've won all the good things that life ever brings, you know what? I've still tasted enough of life's miracle stuff that forever I just have to see.
Oh, keep silent, ye mountains, ye fields and ye fountains, or the sea. Time I must sing. Oh, it's the time to sing praises to the rock of the ages. For this is the time I must sing.
Time I must
if the rocks would cry out, should his praises die out, then the stones must keep silent as long as I breath. For the singing his praise will keep ringing, and I will keep singing my song.
Keep silent, ye mountains, ye fields and ye fountains, for this is the time I must sing. Oh, it's the time to sing praises.
Well, Bill, here's a melody you didn't finish on your scratchings. What is that?
Where'd you find that?
In this pile of...
You're kidding.
...stuff.
Okay, here it is.
I guess you did finish that one. And that would be called their
Jesus.
Yeah.
Wow. And I suppose nobody sang that any more beautifully than Danny did.
But there's something
mere mention of his name can calm the storm, heal the broken, raise the dead. At the name of Jesus, I've seen sin-hardened men melted, derelicts transformed, the lights of hope put into the eyes of a hopeless child. At the name of Jesus, hatred and bitterness turn to love and forgiveness. Arguments cease. I've heard a mother softly breathe his name at the bedside of a child, delirious from fever, and I've watched as that little body grew quiet and the fever brought cool. I've sat beside a dying saint, her body racked with pain, who in those final fleeting seconds summoned her last ounce of ebbing strength to whisper her sweetest name, Jesus, Jesus. Emperors have tried to destroy it. Philosophies have tried to stamp it out. Tyrants have tried to wash it from the face of the earth with the very blood of those who claimed it. Yet it still stands. And there shall be that final day when every voice that has ever uttered a sound, every voice of Adam's race, shall raise in one mighty chorus to proclaim the name of Jesus. For in that day, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is truly Lord. So you see, it was not mere chance that caused an angel one night long ago to say to a virgin maiden, his name shall be called Jesus. Jesus. Say it with me. Jesus. There is something. Something about that name.
When we were younger, we abused our kids, like many of you do, and had them to sing every night, especially if the audience was tough. If nothing else will work, bring out Amy. We always have the same little banter between us. I'd say, Amy, who is your favorite daddy in all the whole wide world? And she says, you are daddy. Who's your favorite piano player in all the world? You are daddy. I said, who's your favorite songwriter in all the world? You are daddy. Who's your favorite singer in all the world? Uncle Danny is daddy. But it's always the same thing. It's fun. But we wrote this song for kids, sing along. I am a promise.
I am a possibility. I am a promise. With a capital P, I am a great big bundle of potentiality. And I'm learning to hear God's voice, and I'm trying to make the right choices. I'm a promise to be anything God wants me to be.
You're a promise to be anything God wants you to be.
I'm a promise to be anything.
Anything.
He wants me to be.